Hey everybody, Edo here, and I am thrilled to introduce Tiffany as guest reviewer today. Tiffany has a YouTube channel called The One Tar where she does fabulous game reviews, almost always going somewhere or at an airport. Really well done, super interesting, and she also was a huge contributor to Liftoff. She helped me understand game reviews, media, Kickstarter, you know, Twitter. She's awesome. A huge part of me doing my reviews is her reviews. So she's going to be reviewing Diamonds. Check it out. Thanks.
Hi, Edo. I know on your channel you usually do things unedited, but given the current nature of where I am, this video is probably going to end up being edited. For your viewers who may or may not know me, my name is Tiffany, and I have a channel called The One Tar on YouTube, which maybe will be linked down below. I'm not really sure how it works over here. It's a lot more freeform, as it will. Well, as freeform as you can be, well, holding all your luggage. Right, coffee acquired. Okay, so this weekend I'm traveling to see family because it's the Halloween weekend, and I'm not going to do a Halloween-y one. I'm going to do a normal one about a game that I would like to play with my family, and I'm super excited that I'm going to be able to play with my family, and that game is Diamonds from Stronghold Games. So Diamonds from Stronghold Games is a trick-taking game similar to Spades or Hearts, which is probably why it's named Diamonds, but it doesn't use a normal playing deck of cards. It uses a special deck of cards, and wow, my hair is like not staying put. It uses a special deck of cards that comes in the game, and this deck of cards has numbers 1 through 15 of the normal suits, Diamonds, Hearts, Clubs, and Spades. It also has little shiny token things in this game, which is a very different thing from Spades or Hearts, and the really important thing that sets this game apart from Spades and Hearts, aside from the separate deck and the shinies, is that you win by having the most shinies, not by taking the most tricks. So the thing with Diamonds, you would play it like you do a normal trick-taking game like Hearts or Spades, except for when you take a trick and you score it, you get to do a special thing depending on what the suit of the trick was. So basically if it's a Hearts, you get, well, I can't remember. All of these things that you can do when you take tricks or play cards out of suit, which I'll explain later, I guess, all have to do with the shinies, which are, I guess I'm supposed to say Diamonds? No, they will not go there. Okay, let's go to a gate and a place where there's no speakers or people. The thing that makes Diamonds really interesting is when you take a trick suit, you do an action, and all those actions have to do with taking shinies from the bank or other players or that kind of stuff and putting them in front of you or in your vault. Every player has a spot for their diamonds, and they have a vault, and at the end of the game, all diamonds outside of your vault are worth 1 point, and then all diamonds inside your vault are worth 2 points. So basically your vault is worth twice as much, and that's amazing. So all the suit actions that you can do on your turn either get you diamonds into your front area, get you diamonds into your vault, or take diamonds from people and then put them in from your front area or put them in your vault or something like that. That's basically how you play Diamonds. The other thing is like the normal rules of if you can't play a card of the suit that started for the trick thing, you can play another suit card, and then you actually get to activate that suit power's action, which is very interesting and unique twist. I like Diamonds as an alternative to Spades or Hearts because growing up my family and I played Spades like crazy. Like we played Spades out. Like we're not allowed to play Spades with certain partnerships anymore because like things happened. The great thing that sets Diamonds apart from Spades or Hearts that I probably should have mentioned at the beginning of this is that Diamonds can work for 2 to 6 players. So you can play with 2 players, or 6 players, or 3 players, or 4 players, or 5 players. And if you're playing with 6 players and you want to play like a team thing, or 4 players and play with a team thing, there's totally team rules. So that's an option if you like the team stuff. If you find a copy, I would recommend picking it up, especially if your family likes trick-taking games, and you like trick-taking games, and you'd be interested in getting your family into more games that aren't the traditional trick-taking games or other games like Monopoly. This is a great gateway step-up game from, like, tricks, because you can just walk in and be like, hey, let's play a new trick-taking game. It's like Spades or Queens, but like a little different. And they will already know how to play half of it because they'll already know how to do the trick-taking mechanics and the whole thing of like playing out a suit and all that kind of stuff. The only thing that they'll have to learn is what happens on the suit actions. And there's a handy little guide card that tells you that. So yeah, if you get a copy off this recommendation, if you do and you enjoy it, let me know. If you do and you don't enjoy it, also let me know. So yeah, thanks again, Edo, and I'll see you all later.
And that was Tiffany reviewing Diamonds. Equally cool, I'm actually reviewing Tribune on her channel right now, The One Tar. You can go check it out. I've linked it below. Hope you enjoyed this review, my review on her channel, and all that fun stuff. Play some good games. Thanks. Bye.